This is a quick but brief overview of the process of ripping koi katsu models and converting them into VR models to be used as models for virtual YouTuber. Be warned, this is not meant to be a long step-by-step how-to tutorial. By using the BEP in Xmod and the plug-in DLLP in Xexport in Koi Katsu Game, you can export the in-game model out into PMX model, which is then passed over to Blender for fixing. In Blender, you need to fix the model by using CAD Blender add-on. It requires you to have some basic 3D modeling skills to mend some clippings and patch gaps in the mesh and vertices in the model. You may need to tune, add and modify materials, bones, shape keys, and even textures. You may even need to utilize the optimization option in CAD Blender. Primarily, the purpose of CAD Blender is to facilitate the ease to create models for VR chat, by which Blender exports out into FBX models that can be processed in Unity to be able to then upload onto VR chat. Bear in mind, CAD Blender does not support direct VRM model conversion. This requires UniVRM in Unity for conversion. In Unity, you need to fix and tune the materials in the FBX model that was exported out from Blender. This may require PMX model textures to be correctly placed in the Unity project depending on how the FBX model was exported out from Blender, because what CAD Blender and Blender itself chuck into the FBX model container file may not be what you'd expect. For example, Blender doesn't export out shading through CAD Blender. It all depends on what CAD Blender chucks out into your FBX model file that may need different approach on how to properly assign materials in Unity. One advice in Blender is to click on Fixed Model whenever you make any mesh or materials changes to the models before you export out into FBX. This whole process can be very tricky and the FBX model may not come out as you would expect in Unity. That may lead to frustration and you giving up. Like what I said about CAD Blender before, it doesn't support direct VRM conversion, so instead of setting up and assigning dynamic bones and bone shape keys like you would do to FBX models to make it work for VR chat, you need to use UniVRM to set up VRM spring bones and correctly assigning bone shapes to your VRM model, which requires exporting out into VRM model and then importing it back in again to make those VRM changes for eye tracking and visons, as well as VRM spring bones. Well, this is the model. It doesn't look perfect as you can see. She kinda looks weird, has issues with minor clippings and other stuff. Around the eyeballs, no eyelid during blinking, etc. I was completely overwhelmed in part due to the large and complexity of the Koi Katsu models. Part of the reason is because I'm a total beginner when it comes to 3D modeling. Plus the fact that I have never used Blender before, only able to do the bare minimum of basics. If I knew more about Blender modeling, I could probably fix and add something to the model. This video being a brief overview of the process is not intended to be a complete tutorial, as doing so would take up too much time making the video length far too long. Maybe in the future, I'll make some videos focusing only one or two process of this entire procedure and showing you guys how it is done. However, I still hope you find this video at least informative and valuable on the possibility of using Koi Katsu to generate some foundational models on which one is able to work on, to further the process of making a VRM model to become a virtual YouTuber. So long then, until next time, take care everyone. Thanks for watching and hope you subscribe.